sitting here for their whole set, then we're gonna talk real quick, and then...
Right here, we're gonna talk?
Yep. And you're gonna announce about the women's voices, and then you're gonna go that way, and they're gonna come in and sit. Don't forget to unmic.
So I take my mic off?
Right.
Mark, just sit on your lap.
I'll go over there and play guitar.
Welcome to Grandma's Attic Music Review. I'm so happy to be with you tonight. It's going to be another one of those wonderful shows. I am so excited to have with us tonight. Tonight it's a duo, and they're here all the way from Texas. I'm just thrilled. I got to see them play at the Knickerbocker a couple of weeks ago. They're absolutely fabulous. Please help me to welcome Jenni, Dale Lord, and Steve Lott.
Thank you. Thank you so much. What an honor it is to be here. Thank you so much for having us. We're wrapping up the end of our Bad Jokes, Good Music tour. It's been really fantastic, except for the jokes, obviously.
They're terrible.
They're terrible.
Terrible.
But I love that. So thanks for having us. This is my very first time here in Connecticut. Beautiful place. I'm looking forward to some whiskey afterwards. That last song was the title track to our previous album, a song I wrote about my very favorite thing in the world, free whiskey. Here's a song from our Never Let Go album. My very first Angry Chirp Revenge song is called Crazy.
Shattered on the floor, and longing for a time when things went my way, and a lost memory from the night before. I must have gone crazy, just lost it completely. What have I done? Thought you were the one, went out of my a good, good girl. But part of me feels some strange in a hurry, while the other part's inside a tilt-a-whirl. And I'm not sure about my usually good intentions, the ones that always had the best of me. Many things I know I ought to question, like an empty can of gasoline. I must have gone crazy, just lost it completely. Whoa. coming up ahead and 1,000 miles behind me in this old Ford, and the memory of her lying in your bed. Thank you so much.
You know, when I wrote that song, obviously I wrote it in Texas. And so I always envisioned the girl running off to Mexico as she's running towards the border. But our whole New England tour, I can only picture her going off to Canada.
Yeah, she's running off to Montreal.
That's right. What a fantastic time we had there in Canada. I love this place. You may never get rid of me. You may never get rid of me. Now, I say that kiddingly because this next song is one of our radio singles. And it climbed the charts very well in Texas, made it all the way up to number 23. It's a duet I did with the one and only Mr. Joe Ely. But the minute we left Texas, the minute it left the charts, so we may should never leave Texas again. I know, tragic.
I think we'll sneak away occasionally.
Come spend the summers here. I don't think I could handle the winters, though. This is from our Free Whiskey album. The song is called Already Gone.
Said I'm going back to West Virginia. Texas plains really ain't my style. I miss the Appalachians in the springtime. God, I haven't seen them in a while. He said I miss my family out in Charleston. And I've been craving mama's apple pie. His baby sister's gonna have her first one, and he'd sure love to be there by her side. So first thing in the morning, he's getting on the plane. He picked the perfect day to leave, cause it's supposed to rain. But what I don't get is why he let me hold on for so long when he was already gone. She said, this time I'm headed up to Nashville. I met a man who says he'll take me. After all these years of searching, I found it. The chance I need to finally be a star. She said each time I left you, I was trying to find a way to make these dreams come true. And she's sorry that she couldn't take me with her. She thought I'd understand more than I do. So first thing in the morning, she's getting on that plane. She picked the perfect day to leave, cause it's supposed to rain. But what I don't get is why she let me hold on for so long when she was already gone. Front door, say all we couldn't say before. So first thing in the morning, he's getting on the plane. She picked the perfect day to leave, cause it's supposed to rain. But what I don't get is why he let me hold on for so long when he was already gone. was already gone. You were already gone.
Thank you so much. One of the biggest highlights of my career thus far is making a duet with Joe Ely. Something I would have loved, always imagined, never really thought it would happen. So now that it has, I'm the luckiest girl I know. We just put out a brand new album before we hit the road. Here's a song you'll find on there. We'll let Steve pull out his fancy resonator guitar. It's called Out of the Blue. Keep them in my heart like it's telling me to. So you never heard me, but you're smart. I'm sure you've got a clue. I can't say that I love you, baby, I think I do. Oh yeah, baby, I think I do. One day I'd like to hold you for more than just a night, 'cause I'd like the chance to top everything. It feels so right. If you thought that it was good before, well, I've got a surprise coming for you. 'Cause I can feel it when I touch you, baby, I think I do. Oh yeah, baby, I think I do. I think I might. I think about you day and night. I think I'm scared. Well, I know it's true, but I can't believe that I found you out of the blue. Baby, I think I do. Right now you're headed northbound, driving so far away. Just my luck, I'd fall for someone clear across the state. So I'm counting down the hours and the minutes until I'm next to you. And with everyone that passes, baby, I think I do. Oh yeah, baby, I think I do. I think I might. I think about you day and night. I think I'm scared. Well, I know it's true, but I can't believe that I found you out of the blue. Baby, I think I do. I think you know. I think these feelings, they have to show. I think I'm scared, but I'll make it through. I can't believe that I found you out of the blue. Baby, I think I do. Out of the blue.
Thank you.
No denying I'm not perfect. No, no, no. No pretending that I love you. But I think you'll find me worth it. Oh, 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 oh. Yeah, I got what you need. So never let go. Some days it's hard to love me. Oh, hello. But I thank God that you do. Because when pushing comes to shoving, oh, hello, I couldn't make it without you. So never let go, when there's pain, when the sky is pouring rain. Never let go, when it seems it'd be easier to leave. And never give up, never give in. It's a crazy love we're in, I know. Never let go. Baby, when your arms surround me, oh, 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 oh. And your hands, they touch my skin, I feel love has finally found me. Oh, 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 oh. Won't you hold me warm? And never let go. Hold me tight. Tell me everything's alright. Never let go. When it seems it'd be easier to leave. And never give up. Never give in. It's a crazy love. Never let go, when there's pain, when the sky is pouring rain. Never let go, when it seems it'd be easier to leave. And never give up, never give in, it's a crazy love.
Thank you so much. That's the title track to the first album that Steve and I ever made together, Jenni Dale Lord Band, Never Let Go. Now, one of the things I love most about our band is we're kind of a mixture of influences. That's why everybody says, what kind of music do you play? And we usually say Americana, because it's kind of all the American music thrown in together. So some things sound a little bit country, some things sound a little bit rock and roll. Like Donnie and Marie all rolled into one.
Well, one song on the album sounds French, so on Free Whiskey. The last song.
I say, hey, I call it Gypsy.
Gypsy, okay.
Gypsy, well. Yeah.
Oh.
This is a little bluesy tune. Bluntry, we like to call it. Take that however you want to. It's called Sometimes the Girl Just Needs the Blues. Mm-hmm.
why she feel the way she do. Sometimes it seems crazy. Sometimes that's how it feels. Sometimes she's just walking around with her heart hanging down to her heels. Sometimes a girl just feels a thing, like a wasp just flew by and in the blink of an eye left her with a sting. Somehow it surrounds her, somehow it just appears. Before she was found on her own, now she feels all alone in her tears. Don't ask why, don't ask why. Sometimes a girl just feels a thing. Stop loving you. She's longing for that Sunday, that Sunday kind of love. The one she's believed all along must be more than a song she cranks up. Don't ask why, don't ask why. No, you can't understand. No, needs the blues. Sometimes a girl just needs the blues. Sometimes a girl just needs the blues. Yes, she do, yes, she do, yes, she do, yes, she do. Sometimes a girl just needs the blues. Yes, she do. Yes, she do, yes, she do, yes, she do. Sometimes a girl just needs the blues. Yeah. Yes, she do, yes, she do. Sometimes a girl just needs the blues.
Thank you very much. That's new music right there. We just released an album, but we're always looking forward to the next one. So you get to hear a bunch of new music at all the shows, which is always fun for me. Maybe fun for you, so you don't have to hear the same songs over and over. This next song is no different. You'll find it on the same album. You'll get the Sometimes a Girl Just Needs the Blues song. One of my favorites, although it's hard to pick a favorite because they're all like my kids. I know you have a favorite kid, but I don't.
You can't say that on TV.
I just did. The song is called Go Do You. Just as good as gold.
So let me help you with your suitcase. Let me find your lucky socks. Don't mind about the memories. Blame the whiskey and the rocks. Don't forget to take that photograph from that crazy night we had in Tennessee. Go do you, and I'll do me. It's beautiful in Kansas. I've heard New York has got it all. And I've been told you haven't lived till you've seen Boston in the fall. So let me help you with your suitcase. Let me find your favorite shirt. Don't mind about the memory. Of course it's gonna hurt. Don't forget to take that photograph from that crazy night we had in Tennessee. Go do you, and I'll do me. I hope you find what you've been missing, and that you have all you can hold. But I'll be right here where you left me, if the road should bring you home. So let me help you with your suitcase. Let me find your cowboy boots. Don't mind about the memories or the place we planted roots. But don't forget to take that photograph from that night you said I'm all you'll ever need. Go do you, and I'll do me.
Thank you very much. You can expect that song sometime around 2050. I'm just, bad joke. I promised you bad jokes. But we're gonna play one more song. Thank you guys so much for spending your day with us. I'm gonna get Steve to sing a duet with me. Another song from our first album together, our Never Let Go album. The song is called There We Were.
Trying to shave my legs and burn my finger, cooking up some mess. Just when I thought things couldn't get no worse, my phone rang. It was you, and baby, there we were. Baby, there we were, just like we always do. Hey there, how you been? Boy, I sure miss you. I know we said it's over, 'cause it never ever works, but some we forget, so baby, there we were. Pulled in your driveway, shaking half to death.
Rang your doorbell, holding my breath. You look so pretty, it should have been a sin. Well, I knew that I should go, but I went on in. Before I knew it, before I said a word, I took you in my arms, and baby, there we were.
Baby, there we were, just like we always do.
Hey there, how you been? Boy, I so miss you. I know we said it's over, cause it never ever works, but somehow we forget. So baby, there we were,
there we were,
there we were.
Once more, this time it'll work. Cause I love you and you love me, and baby, there we were.
So much.
Awesome.
Thank you.
So while Steve and Jen are getting themselves together to come over, I want to introduce you to my friend, my very dear friend, for about, well, let's just say it's been more than 25 years and less than 50. We'll just put it that way, right, Richard?
Closer
this
to
is
the
Richard Douglas.
Than the 25, but yeah.
I want him to tell you about some upcoming events that he's doing some help promoting, so I'm going to turn that over to him real quick, and then we'll have Steve and Jen come over and talk to us. So tell us about what's going on with you.
Well, I'd be happy to do that as soon as I calm down from the spell of Jenni Dalelord and Steve Lott, which is going to take
yeah.
me a few minutes.
They're awesome,
but,
aren't they?
But, oh my God, you know, what an incredibly talented duo, and what a great singer-songwriter Jenni is. So amazing. I mean, I've known Steve from Little Wolf years
right,
back.
For years.
I was heartbroken about that when that band split up, but as soon as I met Jenni, what was it, a week or two ago?
Yep,
a couple of weeks
you fell
ago,
in love.
Wow, and heard, you know, I forgot all about that, and now I got to get all these other CDs because I only have the new one. So anyway, they're fabulous and
okay, so what's say. Going on?
New stuff that's going on. Okay, two big events very quickly. The first one's kind of a real nostalgic thing for us because back
wait.
In the days when you were like a high school student coming in to Imagine buying your colored hairspray to go to the punk shows that we were putting on.
1980.
Yeah, I discovered a band back then called New Johnny Five. And this was, 1980 or so. And, you know, the drummer's brother was my best friend, but, you know, Tom Zapiri and Tim Zapiri, the drummer. You got to come hear this band. He said, I know you're down in the dumps because you moved up from New York. And you said, there's no Ramones, there's no Talking Heads, there's no television around here. Well, you got to come hear this band. So it took me a while before I made the time. And finally, I went down and I heard New Johnny Five. And that very night, I heard the song that was going to be the first song I ever produced in a studio,
right.
to show. With Jay Morosini.
So they're going to be putting together a new show.
They are going to be part of the Towers of New London. Bands of the L&G. You know, there's no more Babas, so we don't say Bands of Babas, but it was also
right.
And New Johnny Five is going to headline that amazing show, and it's coming up on September 22nd at Hygienic Park, right?
Right.
And the band's heavily into rehearsals. They're going to do a series of shows and see how it goes. All the original members and some other great bands from that period, like The Wailz and Cartoons, who I also worked with, are going to be performing.
Wonderful.
So it's going to be amazing.
And the other event that is coming up is very exciting to me.
Yes, and me too. And I wish Jenni was going to be here for it. The other event is Women's Voices 2. This is the second year of the singer, songwriter, performance showcase that Imagine, now it's imaginemystic.com, produces, and it's going to be at the Knickerbocker on October 7th. My partner in this, Christine Ullman, the Beehive Queen, the vocalist for the Saturday Night Live band for the last, I don't know, more than 25 years.
Absolutely.
We'll be headlining it again, and the band, backed by popular demand, Someone You Can X-Ray, who's so amazing.
We love them. We love them.
Is going to be performing, but the other two we're keeping under wraps. We'll make it three if Jenni will come back. But seriously, it's going to be amazing. It's a tribute to my late wife, Karen, who was the first big music promoter, who was female music promoter in Connecticut. And we did so many great shows together.
And it raises money for?
Thank you. Keeping me on track.
I am,
because
I've got
all
an interview
go to,
the, to do.
All the money raised for this goes to the Institute for the Musical Arts, and in particular, the Rock and Roll Camp for Girls in Goshen, Massachusetts, which is
nice.
Run by June Millington, who is the guitar player from the first all-female band that was ever signed to a major contract.
Wonderful.
Fanny.
Well,
a
thank you so
David
much.
A favorite of David Bowie's, a favorite of mine.
Right, absolutely. Thank you so much for
yeah.
doing this, for promoting this music, and for always being the lover of music, and for being my friend. I appreciate that.
That
it's
goes
a
both
good thing.
Ways, my dear.
I really want to get to this interview. I thank you so much for coming on my show.
I'm going to take this mic off. I'm going to go so I can actually see Jenni from the front when I go over there instead of the side or the back. So.
So while he's unmiking and they're miking up, I just want to remind you all that there are exciting and wonderful shows going on all over the place. There's music downtown in New London. I know that there's going to be music on the harbor, down on the harbor. There's going to be music everywhere. You can check that out. Check at New London Matters. They have all that stuff listed, and you can find stuff about all of it on Facebook. I just thank you all so much for watching this show and for supporting local live music. I'm ready to talk to my friends. I think I can call you friends. Can I, Steve? I've known you now for 5 years.
Well, okay.
Okay.
Certainly, of course.
You don't take friends easily. Don't take it personally.
Of course.
That's okay.
Of course.
First of all, I just want to say, because I can, happy birthday.
Oh, thank you very much.
It's a wonderful day to have a birthday.
Glad to be upright still.
Yeah. What, 25 years old? You know, we're...
yeah, well, 26.
26 this year.
Plus
and Jenni,
40.
Welcome to Connecticut.
Thank you for having
welcome
us.
Welcome to New England.
It's been quite a trip. Quite a trip.
You guys are just coming off. You're just at the very end of your New England tour. Tell us a little bit about where you've been and what you've seen and what's been some of the exciting highlights for you.
Well, I think you'll remember all the names of the places better than I would, since you're a seasoned pro of the area.
Oh, dear. Well, we went all the way from Lubbock, Texas to Norfolk, Virginia, first of all.
Nice.
And did the East Coast Music Conference. And a friend of ours has a place there called the Barrel Room.
Yep.
Okay.
And, which is a lot of fun. It's right down in the heart of the city.
All right.
We played there for quite a bit.
Nice.
We were there for a while. And then we worked our way through
West Virginia,
Leesville, and Bluefield.
Louisville.
And
West Virginia is amazing. Have you ever been there?
Yeah. I've been through there.
I loved it. Yeah, I loved it. And some of the best highlights of the trip were going through West Virginia. We found a place called Biscuit World that had all you can eat biscuits and gravy. I'm from Texas.
Nice.
I love biscuits and gravy.
I bet.
So I was very excited about that. And then driving through the Appalachian Mountains with bluegrass music turned up as loud as we could stand it. It was amazing.
Yeah,
it was amazing.
That was a good drive into Pennsylvania to mm-hmm. relative's house.
Yeah, played a show there too, though.
Played a show there at this really cool outdoor, sort of an indoor-outdoor venue by the river.
Nice.
Called the Dam Inn.
The Dam Inn.
I mean, people came from miles around, I must say, because it's
packed.
In the woods.
It was amazing, yeah.
And then we came on up, and the first place we played was, well, the first two gigs we had were in Boston.
That's a great place for music, Boston.
Love Boston.
I wanted to see to it that we played there first.
And we sang that song I've heard you haven't lived until you've seen Boston in the fall. Of course, people were like, what? It was fantastic. Right, right. I love it.
Did you throw your tea into the harbor?
I did.
You did?
I absolutely did.
That was fun, right?
Yeah, and it was the week that we had a whole group of Texans come to hang out with us. And so I had my two little tea bags and I cut them open because I wasn't going to litter, you know.
Right.
So I poured it into my hand and I was like, all right, everybody, grab a pinch of tea. And so we all did. And then we like, one, two, three, and all tossed it in the harbor. It was really nice.
That must have been great
it
fun.
It was so fun.
It makes it really very significant.
It does. I feel like I've done my part.
Well, and you know, we're from Texas, so we know a thing or two about revolution, too.
Yes, you do. And you left the United States, you left New England, and went?
We went to Montreal.
How was that?
Amazing. I'd say it was definitely one of the highlights of the tour. We on a whim, just went up there for 2 days. We played a show in Vermont, in Burlington, and it was only about an hour and a half away from Montreal. So we're like, let's do it. So we left our gig late at night, drove that way. Played hard for a day and a half, and we had a really great time, and there was music festivals going on. The Grand Prix was going on too, so we couldn't have asked for more things to do. It was crazy. I think we walked like 14 miles in one day, according to my Fitbit
Montreal
anyway.
Nice. Yep.
And I forgot to take my walking shoes, so I had to walk.
Were you walking in these heels?
Cowboy boots with heels, yeah.
You can do that.
It was certainly better than these. I would never have made it through
with these. A Texan can walk in cowboy boots.
I can. But on cobblestone streets for 14 miles, your feet start to hurt.
She started out tapping and then wound up clomping.
Let's talk a little bit about music. I've got three CDs here.
Yeah.
I'll hold them up in a little while.
Make sure you give those to Richard when we're done, since he only has the first one.
All right. Well, I don't have two of them either.
I brought a bunch, we can take care of it.
Jen, when did you actually start playing music?
Well, you know, I've been playing music since I was four. My mom put me in piano lessons at 4 years old.
Okay.
And I remember writing my first song at eight about my parents' divorce. And I picked up the guitar at 11 and played various other things, saxophone, and, you know, stuff that you do growing up. But I've just always had music in my soul. And I tried doing other things, but music is where I always went back to. You
right.
know?
You do a little cooking, I hear.
I have a culinary degree, and in my spare time, I like to cook for my friends and my family. That's what I did before I started to pursue music full time. I grew up thinking that I would never be able to survive playing music. You know, it's not a career you want to chase. You'll never make any money. So I never really tried. I kind of dabbled, didn't
I? You have to do it for the love of music, not for the love of money.
Well, I knew I needed to put food on the table. So I went to college, I went to culinary school, did all that stuff. And finally, I just decided I was just going to go for it. And so here we are.
Well, personally, my ears are extraordinarily happy that you pursued music. Now, where did you meet Steve?
Steve and I actually have a mutual friend who put us together. My guitar player from Jenni Dale Lord Band at the time fell in love with a girl from Brazil and moved to Brazil. And so I was in need of a guitar player, and you know, Little Wolf broke up, and so our friend.
That was a very sad day for a bunch of us, by the way.
Well, my gain.
Yeah.
So we met, he came over and we just jammed and we were like, you're hired, let's try this. And 5 years later, here we are.
Steve, what did you think when you first met Jenni?
I was charmed.
Instantly,
yeah, she was charming. And I think it's funny that Hatch said, you need to go see this girl. And I was like, oh, yeah, great.
Just another female singer.
He said, no, he said, shut up, listen to me, you need to go meet her. And so, yeah, I mean, we just sort of hit it off right away. It was... I wasn't sure because I hadn't heard her music. I just knew she was relentless about getting jobs, and I was like, okay. I like that part.
Nice.
But I really, really liked her songwriting right from the get-go. I felt like it was something that I could, you know, help add something to just as a player.
Right.
And she doesn't need any help from me as a songwriter, that's for sure. So it was nice to just sort of get in the groove right there and be able to be her guitarist. And here we are three albums later.
I was gonna ask you, do you guys co-write at all? Do you do any co-writing?
Typically, I have the song and the chord structure, and Steve will usually, we play around at my dining room table and just kind of sit across from each other. And I say, all right, Steve, here's a song. What do you think? And he'll give me his feedback, and he'll put in his own parts that he creates as far as accompaniment goes. So I guess you could call it co-writing in that sense. Yeah, you know, okay. I definitely don't tell him what he needs to play unless I have something very specific that I'm like, well, this is kind of what I have in mind. What can you do towards this overall goal? But yeah, no, he definitely writes his own parts.
My job, I think, is to just sort of help direct it in terms of how it feels. Mm-hmm. Where does it need to go emotionally? And that's, you know, I color it up with my playing that way. And, you know, we've got a shorthand now, so it's like, all right, we can stop on a dime and turn left, turn right, go any direction we want pretty easily.
Well, he's also gotten it down, though, where he pretty much knows by what I'm saying in the song how I want it to go. You know, if it, like, go do you, it's so tender and emotional, he's not going to come in there, you know, he knows exactly.
Well, I did the first time, and she just went, no. No, I was kind of exuberant that day. No, it's exactly what she's describing is, okay, she plays it for me, and then I go, oh, okay, so it's this mood, and so let's find a way to get it into that mood. It works pretty well for us. Yeah,
well, and you guys seem to read each other really well on stage also. Is that just a connection that you two have developed, or was it right from the start?
I think we developed it. Yeah. You know, we each have been the band leaders, and we had to learn how to work as a pair rather than just kind of running with it our own directions. And we've learned to rely on each other and look, you know, like I look to him, and we always want to make sure that we are on the same page. And
we've spent a lot of time in the studio, but we've also, as far as I'm just guessing, I haven't actually counted them, but in 5 years, almost 5 years now, I would say that we're getting really close to or have just passed 1,000 performances.
Okay, while I want you to talk, I want you to tell people where they can find you on the different media menus, and I'm gonna hold these up so that they can get a better view. Never let go. Where can people find you?
Well, you can find all our music on the website, jennydalelord.com. We're on iTunes, Spotify, Amazon Music, any digital outlet that you can find music, you can find us there.
And this right here, Reboot, is the new album. I just want to tell you, it's awesome, it's wonderful, and we are out of time. And I hate that. But would you do us a favor? Absolutely, most important part of the show is you and your music. Could you take us out with a song?
Oh, we'd love to.
All right, thank you. Make sure you undo your mics. While they're getting back, I just want to remind you all that downtown New London is full of mom and pop shops. By that, I mean your neighbors and your friends that are absolutely living in your neighborhood and trying to have a business in your neighborhood. Support those mom and pop shops, okay? Get out there and spend your money with your friends and your neighbors. If we support our economy by supporting our mom and pop shops, the money stays here in our neighborhood. We need that to happen. So I love you all so much. Thank you so much for tuning in to the Grandma's Attic Music Review. And with that, here are Jenni and Steve, and they're gonna take us out with a song. Until next week, everybody. Bye-bye and God bless.
Yesterday, I was just a girl living at home, and my mama would yell down the street, kids, it's time to come meet, and we'd go running in, oh, to be back there again. Kids can heal the pain of anyone. only I know. Oh, to be back there again. Like you're getting older, and I'm not sure that means wise will come knocking at my door. Lately getting older means that all I see are things a little older than before. But when I was 17 and they crowned me cotton queen, and gravity was my friend. Yeah.